Hello, my name is Ilona. Happy Easter! And I will color the eggs in a traditional Latvian way, but I believe that it's not only traditional in Latvia. And I will use not only traditional coloring stuff, but one traditional way how to color the eggs is in onion skins. So I just bought a lot of onions. Well, the problem is, yes, I know every year that Easter will come, but I always forget to collect the onion skins. But I have these red onions, and actually red onion skins are quite dark, and I remember last year I actually used a lot of onion skins, and eggs had dark enough color. I'll just peel the onions and put in this kettle or pot. I'll use just regular brown eggs, because onion skins will make these eggs look even more brown. Well, I will show you pictures actually how I made eggs in some previous years. One year I used decoupage technique, but of course I didn't use regular decoupage glue, which is used for vases or bottles. But I used egg white and just glued these napkins around them. I also used onion skins and other stuff, and I added some leaves around the eggs to make these patterns, or some grains and stuff. I am not sure yet what I will make this year. Yes, and also I bought some white eggs, which are good for if you want to use maybe some different colors which are lighter or brighter. And I will use green tea. I just bought regular green tea, and I will boil some of the eggs in this green tea. I will add, I think, all these half these packages. And before putting eggs inside, of course, this stuff like onion skins or tea have to boil for a while, and not only after that you can add eggs inside. If you want to add some leaves, you can put a string around the leaf, or I just put them in socks. I will use this turmeric. I believe it will color the eggs in bright yellow color, but I am not really sure. Maybe, I don't know, I have a food coloring. Maybe I can try to do something with this food coloring. Maybe it will work. Also, there is a lot of possibilities, there's a lot of stuff what you can use. I believe even coffee can be used. I think spinaches can be used, but beets can be used, or even grass. Well, I don't know how to explain it in English. The grass, which usually are cut in summer for animals to eat in winter, and after that grass there is a small, like a dust leftover. In the spring, when there is most of the grass already used for the animals, this dust is used for egg coloring. But it will be something similar like green tea. So obviously I don't have animals and grass. No, well, I have animals, two animals actually. Okay, now I will go and color the eggs, and then later I will show you the result. Maybe it will be even later on evening. But at the moment, bye and see you later. Okay, I finished the eggs. I will show a picture how it turned out. Onion skins always work great. I will show you, probably. No, not probably, I will definitely show you. So, these are the eggs in onion skins. After boiling them in onion skins, I left them in that water for a while. Also, I added this year to all these waters, wait a minute, vinegar. Because I think maybe it helps to stick that color better. So yeah, this is the onion skin. It's really very beautiful. And also I rubbed the olive oil around them to make them shiny. And the next one will be green tea. But actually, in green tea, these eggs didn't. Well, in green tea, the eggs was quite light, and I actually, after taking them out from this green tea, I don't know, water, I added to the red onion skin water to lay there for a few minutes, and the color turned out much better comparing to just onion skin. There is a difference, as you can see. Yes, also I tried in this one to color this one turmeric or something. Also boiled the water with turmeric for a while, then added the eggs, then left these eggs after for a few minutes, added salt, added to the water, vinegar, and the eggs turned out, these are white eggs, and well, I used white eggs for this one, and turned out quite good, better than last year. So these are brown eggs which are used. I used brown eggs, and they are the result is also brown, but different shade of brown. And also this one was a brown egg. And also I tried food coloring, but it didn't turn out very good in food coloring. It's kind of greenish, yes, but not good enough. And in red, it's not very good. This one actually is quite interesting, quite good. Also in red color, I don't know why this egg is different comparing to this one. Also, another thing, is it because of vinegar? I know if you add salt when you boil the eggs, if the egg is cracked, all that stuff don't goes out from the egg all around the kettle. But probably vinegar prevents them from breaking, because I didn't break any egg. Not a single egg is actually cracked this year. And I wanted to, usually what I'm doing, I use these broken eggs in a salad, and this year I don't know which one I can use in a salad. Probably I will use these fails, which is not very beautiful. Also I don't need a lot of eggs for the salad. And also I want to share with my daughter's eggs. She made she wanted to make the eggs like budgies. So she just used regular coloring pencils on these white eggs, and it looks like budgies, and she said it was very easy to draw on these eggs, because yeah, it felt like a paper.
Oh, it's as easy as paper.
Yeah, it was
basically
as easy
it's
as
that
paper.
Easy.
Oh.
You can just use normal pencils and draw on them.
Yeah, only the only one thing I think, I am not sure if this is edible. Maybe you will have to wash them before eating. Before eating.
Pencil.
Well,
I mean, like, if you break them off, it's not gonna go through the shell.
Yes, but when you will take off this, how do you call this? Not skin, but
the
shell, eggshell. It's eggshell.
Yeah.
Your finger will touch this pencil, and when you clean, you will touch
some coloring.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's best to be careful with that.
Well, okay. So yeah, well, actually, eggs turned out good. I like the result. like always, just made different color eggs. Yeah. So yeah, happy Easter.
Happy Easter, everyone.
Yes, and thanks for watching, and goodbye.